In this video, we're going to talk just for a minute about something called scientific notation. This is a very, very helpful math tool that helps out in a lot of different scientific fields like astronomy and physics and chemistry. What it does is it helps us very easily express really, really big numbers and really, really small numbers. So just to kind of motivate this a little bit, let's say we were doing an astronomy problem and we were talking about light years. That's the distance that light travels in an entire year, which is obviously a really long distance. Well, that distance would be 9,460,730,472,580,800 meters. Really long distance. And if we wanted to work with that number and do some calculations with that number, such as the number of light years or the distance of 5 light years or something like that, it would just be too bulky and cumbersome to multiply this guy times another number or add it to a number or subtract it. It's just too big to handle. So it would be better if we had this, you know, something that's a little bit more of a condensed notation. And that's exactly what scientific notation is. So scientific notation, a number written in scientific notation looks like this. It's A times 10 to the B, where there's some restrictions on A and B. A has to be greater than or equal to 1, but strictly less than 10. And then B has to be an element of the integers. So B has to be an integer. Now, what's the deal with A being greater than 1 but less than 10? What we want to make sure is that A only has a 1's place. Like 9.7 would be great for A because it just has a 1's place. The numbers we want to stay away from for A would be like 13.221. Because having 13, that has a tens place as well, which is larger than we want for A. So it has to be under 10 to make sure you're at most 9 point something to have a ones place only, but greater than or equal to 1 so that you're not just a decimal that doesn't even have a ones place. And then the reason we want B to be an integer is because it's super easy to multiply by multiples of 10. Every time you multiply by 10, you're going to move a decimal place. And so if you add times 10 to the fifth, then you're only moving the decimal place 5 times and so on and so forth. So basically you're keeping A and then moving the decimal place left or right, depending on whether your integer B is positive or negative. So let's quiz ourselves here real quick and see if we can tell which of these numbers are in scientific notation. The first one is 2.71 times 10 to the fifth. That looks great to me. The A has a ones place only. It's 2.71. It's not 12.71 or 112.71. It just has a leading 2, and 5 is an integer. Now, 0.399 times 10 to the negative 8th, I don't think that's going to be in scientific notation. The negative 8 is an integer, that's fine, but the 0.399 is not between 1 and 10. 2.71 is between 1 and 10, but 0.399 is not. It doesn't even have a 1's place. Lastly, 1.291 times 10 to the negative 1.5, that's not in scientific notation. The 1.291 is between 1 and 10, but negative 1.5 is not an integer. So make sure you're very confident in what a number in scientific notation looks like. Now, probably one of the more common questions that you'll see is that someone will ask you to convert back and forth from scientific notation into what we call standard notation. Now, to go from scientific notation back to standard notation, you're basically going to be moving the decimal of A left or right. And whether it's left or right depends on your exponent B. You're going to move the decimal right if B is positive because you're making the number bigger. You have multiples of 10. And then you're going to move the decimal left if the exponent is negative. So a simple example, let's say we had 2.71 times 10 to the fourth. Well, since this is 10 times 10 times 10 times 10, four factors of 10, this number is going to get larger, and we're going to move this decimal place right four units, since the base, or the B, not the base, but the B was greater than zero. So this would be 27100. Move it once, twice, three times, four times. So 2.71 times 10 to the fourth is the same as 27,100. And this makes perfectly good sense. If you wrote 10 to the fourth out long ways, 2.71 times a one with four zeros. So this would actually be the same as 2.71 times 10,000, which will make it 27,100. Now, if the exponent B had been negative, we would have moved this decimal place left a certain number of units and made the number much, much smaller. All right, and then lastly, what if we go in the other direction? What if we have a number in standard notation and we want to put it in scientific notation? Well, the most important thing is to make sure that this leading A has only a ones place. So what we'll do is we'll move the decimal left or right or however many units we need to move it so that it's just past the first non-zero digit. So we'll have one digit and then the decimal. So we'll just be filling up a ones unit, not a ones and a tens place. And then lastly, depending on how many places you move your decimal left or right, we need to choose an appropriate value for B, either positive or negative. So let's try an example. Let's say we had 0.00325. Well, this is in standard notation. Let's see if we can write it in scientific notation. So we would need to have as our A 3.25. It's the same number, but I moved this decimal place 1, 2, 3 units to the right. So we'd have 3.25 times 10 to the something. Now, if we start with 3.25 and we want to get back to 0.00325, this decimal place will need to move to the left to get there, which means we'll need to move negative 3 units. Or negative three places to the left, since it's negative, of course. So anyways, yeah, we're trying to make this number smaller, so it goes 1, 2, 3 places to the left, and we designate that with a negative exponent for the 10. All right, let's try one more in closing. Let's say we had 4,990,000. And that's good, 4,990,000. So we'd call this 4.99. But now 4.99 we would need to make larger to get to 4,999,000. So how many decimal places will we need to move this guy to the right? Well, if the decimal place was here, we need to move it 6 places to the right. So it would be 4.99 times 10 to the 6th power. So anyway, this is how we go from standard notation back to scientific notation. In the upcoming videos, we'll work a little bit more with scientific notation, such as how to do scientific notation on a calculator and how to multiply and divide with scientific notation as well.